Now I want people to figure out that things are right for them based on their luck, circumstance. What's their beautiful eyes?
Yeah.
Yes, maybe they're not an entrepreneur because they don't have incredible lack of fear, but maybe that they are incredibly compassionate, unbelievably analytical, remarkably competitive, incredibly gorgeous, wonderfully funny. Like, let's lean into what we're fucking awesome about. Everybody's spending all their time on what they suck at.
Yeah.
Themselves, they're doing that. And I promise you, everybody else is spending all their time telling you what you suck at.
Yeah.
I'm spending all my time thinking about what I'm fucking awesome at.
Yeah.
And I'm spending all my time trying to figure out what everybody else is awesome at. Some of it's very obvious, like beautiful eyes. Others are like, hey, you're a good fucking kid. Keep listening to me. You know, like, yeah, that's what's going on.
But that's because of awareness of story. It's like, we're all so addicted to watching other people's stories that we don't have a high awareness of our story. And we're not telling ourselves, like, well, you just explained all your connections from your past to your parenting to school. You've created the story arc that fits you, that works for you, because you could tell yourself a different story about that.
But what also happens as you evolve into it, what people don't understand about getting to a place of being happy with yourself, it starts giving you foundation to address what you're not as good at.
Yes, 100%.
Like, 20 years ago, I couldn't speak to, first, I didn't know this about myself, but today I could speak to my lack of candor along the way is a shortcoming of mine as a manager. And over the last 5 years, Vayner's in a healthier place because I realized in my lack of being interested in conflict, I would hold it to myself, but then I would pull the rug from underneath you when I would fire you without giving you context along the way, even though my thing was like, fuck, don't you realize how shitty you're doing?
Yeah.
But no, that's not your responsibility. You're in your own framework. That's not something I could say out loud 10 years ago.
Yes, but you can now.
100%.
Yeah.
Because when you dig in and deep down, triple down on happiness, optimism, self-love, you get to a place where you get such into a good place that you can start putting your toe into your shortcomings.
Yeah, I so agree. I so agree.
You can't do
and
that
we're doing it the other way around. Majority of people are doing it the other way around.
You're not in love with yourself, so you're not in a place where you can talk about your vulnerabilities. So what you do is you start calling out the vulnerabilities that you have in others.
Yes, absolutely. And then it grows, because the more you're meditating on other people's vulnerabilities, the more they even become yours. I've seen that sometimes when you keep talking about and thinking about and fixating on someone else's, you start mirroring them.
Do you know what I just realized? I actually spend no time on judging people's shortcomings, only focusing on their strengths.
Mm.
I don't even have the capacity or the room left. You're right, it's optimism. Like, why? Yeah. Everything else is pessimistic.
Absolutely. And one of the best things I love about that is when you're all in on your strengths, you appreciate other strengths, but it also limits your envy and jealousy.
I'm blown away by my inabilities on those two things.
Mm.